That's very, very interesting. Yeah, I hope you have already watched my video on powers of numbers, I mean the meaning of powers of numbers, as well as the multiplication rule on powers of numbers. In this lesson, I'm going to take you through powers of numbers, but this time, the division rule. Okay, so pay particular attention. Yeah, so we still have our powers of numbers. Powers of numbers. In my previous video, I asked this question. What is 5 raised to the power 0? By the end of this video, we would be able to get an answer to 5 raised to the power 0. Okay, division rule. The division rule is very, very simple. Here it goes. A raised to the power m divided by A raised to the power n is equal to A raised to the power m minus n. Yes. Or A raised to the power m out of A raised to the power n is equal to A raised to the power m minus n. They are all the same, and try as much as possible to keep them in mind. We are going to use examples to explain the rule. Okay, fine. Now, let us assume that we have our powers in this form. 6 raised to the power 5 divided by 6 raised to the power 2. According to the rule, what we have 6 raised to the power m, so that happens to be 5, minus n, that is 2. Okay, so 6 raised to the power 5 divided by 6 raised to the power 2 happens to be 6 raised to the power 5 minus 2 happens to be 3. Is that right? Let's check it out. Now, what is 6 raised to the power 5? It means we are multiplying 6. How many times? 5 times. Okay, so here we have 6 times 6 times 6 times 6 times 6. Yes. So, divided by, here we have 6 raised to the power 2. It means we are multiplying 6 by itself twice. So, 6 times 6. And that gives us what? 6 raised to the power 3. Now, the 6 here divides the 6 there, and the 6 here also divides the 6 there. How many of the 6 are we left with? 1, 2, 3. And that is what we have here. So 6 times 6 times 6 gives us 6 raised to the power 3. Well, if you think working in this form is a little difficult for you, then you can try changing the question from this form to that form. So how do you do that? Okay, now this time we have 6 raised to the power 5 divided by 6 raised to the power 2. That gives us 6 raised to the power 5 minus 2. So here we can rewrite it in this form. 6 raised to the power 5 divided by 6 raised to the power 2. Yes. And then we say we have 6 raised to the power 5 minus 2. Now, what is 6 raised to the power 5? It means you have 6 times 6 times 6 times 6 times 6. Out of 6 raised to the power 2 is 6 times 6. So here we have 6. Now, what is 5 minus 2? That is 3. Okay. Now, from here, you realize that the 6 there divides the 6 here, the 6 there divides the 6 here. So it means you have to have many of the 6? 1, 2, 3. So it tells us that I have 6 times 6 times 6. And how do you represent this in terms of powers? That is 6 raised to the power 3. So it is true. Yeah. So this simply tells us that our formula, that is the division rule, is very, very true. Let me take you through another example. This time we have 4 raised to the power 7 times 4 raised to the power 1. And that gives us 4. 4 raised to the power 7 divided by 4 raised to the power 1. Good. That gives us 4 raised to the power 7 minus 1. Okay. So here, what do you do? 4 raised to the power 7 is 4 times 4 times 4 times 4 times 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7. Now divide by 4 raised to the power 1, so it means only 1. Okay, so we have 4. Now that is 7 minus 1. That is 6. Okay, now the 4 here divides the 4 there. So now let's count the number of 4s we have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we have 4 times 4 times 4 times 4 times 4 times 4. How are you going to represent this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it means you have what? 4 raised to the power of 6. So that is true. We can use the other method to solve it. So here we have 4 raised to the power 7 out of 4 raised to the power 1. And that gives us 4 raised to the power 7 minus 1. So here it tells us that we have 4 times 4 times 4 times 4 times 4 times 4 times 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 out of 4. Yes, that gives us 7. 4, 7 minus 1. So we have 4, yes. 7 minus 1 also is 6. So check it out. 4 goes into itself, it goes into this one. So let's count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it means you have 4 times 4 times 4 times 4 times 4 times 4. That gives us 4 raised to the power of 6. Yes. Okay, fine. This, I'm going to give you another example. This, I'm going to use just variables to do that. Okay, so check it out. Now I can have p raised to the power 3 divided by p raised to the power 2. Yes. Per our formula, it tells us that we have p raised to the power 3 minus 2. Yes. So now what do we have here? Now p3, so we have p times p times p divided by p times p. That gives us p, 3 minus 2 is 1. Okay, fine. So the p here divides the p there, the p here divides the p there. We have only p. And what is p? Yeah, p is p1. So please, take note of this. It is very, very important. Right, now let us move on. We can use the other method. This time we have p3 out of p2. Yes, that gives us p 3 minus 2. So here we have p times p times p out of p times p. That gives us p. 3 minus 2 is 1. Good. So now the p here divides the p, the p here divides the p. So now we have only p is equal to p1. Yes. I asked you to take note of this because under normal circumstance, any number that we write is raised to what? 1. But normally we do not write that. Please take note of that. So p is equal to p1, or p is equal to p raised to the power 1, or p is equal to p raised to the power 1. I'm going to give you another example this time using constants for me to prove, for you to understand it better, that yes, any number that we have should be raised to the power 1. Just that we do not do that. Okay. So again, now
we have 4 raised to the power 4 divided by 4 raised to the power 3. Okay. And by our formula, we have 4 raised to the power 4 minus 3. So check it out. Here we have 4 times 4 times 4 times 4. Yes. And then divided by 4 times 4 times 4. That gives us 4. Now 4, 4 minus 3 is 1. Okay. So the 4 here divides by 4, the 4 there divides by 4, the 4 here divides by 4. So we have only 4, which is equal to what? 4, 1. And this is exactly what I was talking about. So you realize that they are the same. 4 and then 4 raised to the power 1 are the same. So whenever I write a number, we are talking of a number raised to the power 1. That is, a number multiplying itself once. Just that you don't bring the number or you don't bring the power 1. Okay, well, let's use the other form to solve it. So here we have 4 raised to the power 4 out of 4 raised to the power 3. That gives us 4 raised to the power 4 minus 3. Okay, so here we have 4 times 4 times 4 times 4 out of 4 times 4 times 4. That gives us 4. 4 minus 3 is 1. So 4 here divided by 4, 4 here divided by 4, 4 here divided by 4. So we have 4 is equal to 4, 1. Yes, so can I use any of the method to prove? Okay, I've stopped my question, my question. What is 5 raised to the power 3? Please. Whenever the power of a number is 0, the answer is 1. How do we prove that? That is what I'm going to do now. So, let us assume that we have a number A raised to the power 0. Please, the answer is always 1. Take note of this. Just as we have the 5 here. So this one gives us 1. How? Okay, now we have a number like 2 raised to the power 3 divided by 2 raised to the power 3. Now from our formula, we have 2 raised to the power 3 minus what? 3. Yes. Okay. So here it tells us that we have 3, 2 times 2 times 2. Yes. Divided by 2 times 2 times 2. That gives us 2. 3 minus 3 is not 0. Let's check it out. Now this 2 divides this 2. This 2 also divides that 2. This 2 also divides that 2. So we have 1 divided by what? 1. That gives us 2. And there is an important note you have to take note of. Please, anytime you are sharing a number of items, it is still the number of items. For example, 7 out of 1 is 7. Because 1 sharing 7 is still 7. 6 out of 1 is still 6. 100 out of 1 is still 100. B out of 1 is still B. So 1 out of 1 is still 1. So having 1 out of 1 here, what do you write? 1. So 1 is equal to 2 equal to 1. That's what I'm talking about. So 2 raised to the power 0 is what? 1. Okay, fine. Let me use the other method to explain to you. Now this time we say we have 2 raised to the power 3 out of 2 raised to the power 3. The answer is 2 raised to the power 3 minus 3. Okay, let's just prove it. So 2 times 2 times 2 out of 2 times 2 times 2. That gives us 2, 3 minus 3. That is a 0. Okay, so 2 here divides by 2, 2 here divides by 2, 2 here divides by 2. So we have 1 out of 1 is equal to 2 to the power 0. So we have 1 is equal to 2 to the power 0. And that is what I'm talking about. Yes, so please take note. Whenever you have a power of 0, yes. It means the answer is what? Okay, fine. So let me use this base fact to further prove to you. Okay, fine. So we can have something like this. We can have something like this. 5 raised to the power 4
divided by 5 raised to the power 4. Yes, that gives us 5, 4 minus 4. Okay, so now it tells us here that we have 5 times 5 times 5 times 5, yes, divided by 5 times 5 times 5 times 5. Okay, and that gives us 5, 4 minus 4 is not 0. Okay, now the 5 here divides the 5, the 5 here divides the 5, the 5 here divides the 5, and then the 5 here also divides the 5. So you have 1 divided by 1, that gives us 5. Yes, so 1, 1. Okay, so 1 divided by 1, and then we have 5 raised to the power of 0. And then we know that 1 divided by 1 is still 1. So we have 1 is equal to 5 raised to the power of 0. Okay, now let's continue. We can use the other form to prove. So we have 5 raised to the power of 4 out of 5 raised to the power of 4. And the answer happens to be 5 raised to the power of 4 minus 4. Okay, so here it tells us that we have 5 times 5 times 5 times 5 out of 5 times 5 times 5 times 5. That gives us 5. 4 minus 4 is not 0. So the 5 here divides the 5. The 5 here divides the 5. The 5 here divides the 5. So it means you have 1 out of 1, that gives us 5 to the power 0. Yes, so it tells us that here you have 1 is equal to 5. Yes. And so that is what we are talking about. Whenever you have a number raised to the power 0, please, the answer is what? 1. And that is what we are talking about. Because 1 is equal to 5, it's the same as 5 raised to the power 0 is equal to 1. So we can write this one as 5 raised to the power 0 is equal to 1. Or 5 raised to the power 0 is equal to 1. Okay, this time let me use the A as an example to complete the whole thing. Okay, fine. I hope you are following. So this time I have A raised to the power 5 divided by A raised to the power 5. Yes. And that gives us A 5 minus 5. Okay, so here it tells us that we have A times A times A times A times A divided by A times A times A times A times A. Okay, that gives us A raised to the power of 0. Because 5 minus 5 is not 0. Okay, so now the A here divides the A there, 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 and the A here divides the A. So we have 1 divided by 1, that gives us A raised to the power of 0. Okay, fine. So here it tells us that we have 1 is equal to A raised to the power of 0. So you see A raised to the power of 0 is equal to 1. Yes, so we have proven our point. Okay, fine. So we can say we have A raised to the power of 5 out of A raised to the power of 5. That gives us A raised to the power of 5 minus 5. So here it means that we have A times A times A times A times A out of A times A times A times A times A, that gives us A raised to the power of 0, because 5 minus 5 is 0. So the A here divides the A, the A here divides the A, the A here divides the A, the A here divides the A. So we have 1 over 1, that gives us 5. That gives us A raised to the power of 0. So we have A raised to the power of 0. So this time we have 1 is equal to A raised to the power of 0. Yes. Of which you can write as A raised to the power of 0 is equal to 1. So please take note of that. Oh yes, this is how I can bring this lesson also to a successful end. Well, thank you so much.